Good afternoon and welcome to Baku. This was the arena, if you think back to 2017, of one of the most eventful races of modern history, with controversy behind the safety car, last second overtakes, and a historic podium for Williams and for Lance Stroll. So let's find out what lies in store for us this year. It's time for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. The Baku City Circuit measures roughly 6 kilometres and is made up of 20 corners and 2 DRS zones. The circuit winds around the narrow city, through the old town, and even brushes against the city's medieval walls. However, as beautiful as the setting is, this track is also a ferocious technical challenge, where the smallest of mistakes could lead to catastrophic consequences for all of our drivers. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
But from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position with Charles Leclerc alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Vettel, Albon, Sergio Perez, and Ricciardo, Raikkonen, Sainz, Giovinazzi, and Lando Norris. Stroll, Ocon, Lewis Hamilton, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Grosjean, Verstappen, Magnussen, Pierre Gasly, and Daniel Kvyat. Russell, the rookie, De Vries, and Nicholas Latifi. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
We'll be right back. seconds, they're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are 4 laps old. We think they've got 2 stops remaining. The time last lap was at 1:49.8.
Here's our winner, pulling their Ferrari into Parc Fermé. What a fantastic race it was. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
Here come our winners now. A thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again. Let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Max Verstappen seemed to just effortlessly weave through the other drivers today without a care in the world. He was definitely my driver of choice.
Let's move on to the constructors. The current championship leaders still hold top spot. That gap is getting smaller. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action soon.